In this video, we can solve this question. Find all positive integers n such that 2 to the power n plus 7 to the power n is a perfect square. This question is from Australian Math Olympiad. We can consider different cases. Let's see the first one. When n equals 1, then 2 to the power n just 2 to the power 1, then plus 7 to the power n power 1, then here's 9, then here 3 squared. That's a perfect square. So that's why n equals 1 is a solution. That's for the first case. Now let's see the second case. Second case is when n is bigger than 1 and also n is an odd number. Because n is bigger than 1, that means n is bigger than or equal to 2. Then for 2 to the power n, it has a factor of 4. So then the remainder is 0. 1 is divided by 4. Now let's see 7 to the power n. For 7, we can put as 8 minus 1, then to the power n. Then we can use a binomial formula to explain this one. Then 1 is divided by 4. The remainder depends on the last term of the expansion, which is negative 1 to the power n, because other terms have a factor of 8. So here, just divided by 4. Because n is odd number, so that's why the remainder just negative 1. Remainder negative 1 is the same as remainder 3, because negative 1 plus 4 is a 3. So now let's see. Then we have 2 to the power n, then plus 7 to the power n, then the remainder just here, 0 plus 3, then just 3. 1 divided by 4. Now let's see the general case. For any natural number m, then we can write m as here, just 4k plus r. Here k is an integer. Then r is a remainder 1 divided by 4. So that's just taken from 0, 1, 2, to 3. Now let's see m squared. Then m squared, just here, 4k plus r squared. When it's divided by 4, then the remainder just depends on the last term, r squared, because other terms has a factor of 4. Then r here from 0 to 3. Then the remainder of r squared when divided by 4 equals 0 or 1. So here, divided by 4. Then we can easily check it. For example, if r equals 3, then 3 squared is 9. Then 9 divided by 4 is 1. Okay, so that means for m squared, the remainder is 0 or 1 when divided by 4. So now let's compare these two. So that means if 2n plus 7 to the power n is a perfect square, so then the remainder should be 0 or 1 when it's divided by 4. But you see here, the remainder is 3, so it's not consistent. So that's why we have the conclusion here. So that means for this case, there's no solution. Okay, so here. So now let's see the next case. So next case is when n is bigger than 1 and the n is an even number. Then for this case, we can put n as 2j. Then j is a natural number. Then here for 2 to the power n, then plus 7 to the power n, just 2 to the power 2j, then plus 7 to the power 2j. Then 2 squared, that's 4. Then 4 to the power j. 7 squared, that's 49. Then 49j. Then for 4, we're going to put as 3 plus 1. Then to the power j. Then 49 equals 48 plus 1. Then 48 equals 3 times 16. Then here power j. So then why are we doing this? Because we want to know what is the remainder when divided by 3. So you see here, so they use a binomial expansion. So when it's divided by 3, the remainder just depends on the last term, which is 1 to the power j. Same thing here. The remainder is 1 to the power j when divided by 3. So then here, just remainder is a 2. Then here, divided by 3. So then we have here just a 2 to the power n plus 7 to the power n has a remainder 2 when divided by 3. Okay, so now let's see the general case. So for any natural number m, then we can put m as here just 3k plus r. So k is an integer, then r is a remainder when divided by 3. So r equals 0, 1, 2. Okay, so then m squared. Then m squared, just here, just 3k plus r, then squared. So then the remainder, once divided by 3, just equals the last term of the expansion, just r squared. Then r from 0, 1, 2. Then the remainder, when divided by 3, just 0 or 1. Here, divided by 3. Again, we can easily check it. For example, r equals 2, then 2 squared is 4. 4 divided by 3, remainder is 1. So that means m squared has a remainder either 0 or 1 when divided by 3. So that means if 2 to the power n plus 7 to the power n is a perfect square, so then it has a remainder 0 or 1 when it's divided by 3. But you see here, the remainder is 2. They are not consistent. So that means there is no solution. So for this case. So that's why I combine the three situations. So then we have the final conclusion. So that is n equals 1 is the only solution for this question. Thanks for watching.